Hello everyone, so I welcome you all for the engineering metrology lab. So in this video I am going to explain so how the alignment test on lathe machine is carried. So the quality and accuracy of the finished work so depends on the accuracy of the machine tool used in their production. So the machine tools must be able to produce the work pieces of a given accuracy within prescribed limits consistently. So for this reason, so the machine tools are tested at different stages during the assembly, after assembly, erection, repairs or overhauls as per accuracy chart. So that's why we are going to conduct the alignment test on the lathe machine to check the errors on the various parts of the lathe machine. So the aim of the experiment is to carry the alignment test on the lathe for one is a true running of headstock center. So if there is a error in the headstock center, results in eccentricity while turning of the workpiece. And the second one is the movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed and the line of centers parallel to the bed and the tailstock parallel to the bed. So first one is true running of headstock center. So in this, this is the headstock center. So it has the conical part at the front portion. So we place the dial indicator or the feeler of the dial indicator is placed perpendicular to this slide slant faces. And then we will rotate the headstock center and then we will see what is the variation in the headstock center. So that will be shown on the dial indicator. So the maximum permissible error in this case is allowed is 0.01 mm. And the second one is, so in the true running of headstock center, the dial gauge is mounted on the upper slide. So are on the saddle, right? So the dial gauge is mounted on the saddle. And the second one is movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed. So in this case, this is the mandrel. So mandrel is placed between the two centers of the lathe machine. There is a live center, that is our headstock center, and there is a dead center. So here the dial gauge is mounted on the upper slide and then I will rotate the upper slide. So the upper slide, if you rotate the upper slide screw, so the upper slide will move along the guideways. So the dial indicator will move from right from one point to the one end to the other end of the mandrel. So the movement is restricted by the movement of the slide. The length that depends upon the length of the slide. As the upper slide length is shorter, so the movement of the dial indicator is also right short distance. So the dial indicator is moved by a short distance on the mandrel. So if there is any deviation observed, that will be shown on the dial indicator. So first we place the dial indicator feeler on the mandrel and then we will set the zero. When the filler touches the work mandrel, then we will set the dial indicator pointer to zero position. Then the upper slide is screw is rotated, then the upper slide will move parallel to the bed. So if there is any error, that will be recorded or shown on the dial indicator. So the maximum permissible error allowed is 0.02 mm. So for conducting the movement of upper slide and the line of centers parallel to the bed and the tailstock parallel to the bed, these two, movement of upper slide and the line of centers parallel to the bed, so we need a mandrel. So what are the apparatus required for conducting these two? So one is mandrel and there is a dial gauge. And the line of center, third one is the line of centers parallel to the bed. So in this case, the case also we require a mandrel and there is a dial indicator. So here the mandrel is fixed between the two centers, that is live center and dead center. And the dial indicator is mounted on the either saddle or upper slide. And then the carriage is moved. Carriage is moved on the guide wheels. So the dial indicator or the feeler of the dial indicator is placed on the top of the mandrel. And then we will set the zero position for the pointer. And then we will move the carriage. So the dial indicator initially we place here, that is at the one end, and then it is moved to the other end. And then we observe what is the variation on the line of centers. That is shown on the dial indicator. So the maximum permissible error is 0.01 to 0.03 mm in most of the cases. And tailstock parallel to the bed, fourth one is, so in this case, so this is the tailstock, this is the barrel. So on the barrel, so we will place the dial indicator. The feeler of the dial indicator is placed on the barrel. So this dial indicator is mounted on the upper slide. And then the tailstock is, screw is rotated. Then the tailstock will move in and out. So the dial indicator will reads the variation in the movement of the tailstock parallel to the bed. So that we will note down on the table. So the maximum permissible error is 0.01 per 100 mm length. If we move the tailstock barrel through 100 mm length, the maximum error is allowed only 0.01 mm. So while conducting the experiments, we need to note down the dial gauge readings. For that, we require the table. So we are going to conduct the four tests: true running of headstock center, movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed, line of centers parallel to the bed, and tailstock parallel to the bed. So the dial gauge reading is we will note down under the error column. So this is the procedure we need to adopt. So now I will explain, I will show the video, so how this test will be conducted. So this is the carriage. So we have the wheels to move the carriage, and also there is a screw, so which can be used to move the upper slide also. So here the dial gauge is mounted on the base. Dial gauge base is mounted on the upper slide. And then the dial gauge feeler is mounted on the mandrel. Now we will set the dial gauge pointer to zero position. Now we are conducting the, so here we are moving the carriage. That means the line of centers parallel to the bed. So we are conducting the test, that is the line of centers parallel to the bed. So in this case, the dial indicator stand is mounted on the upper slide, and then the dial indicator feeler. So this is called the feeler, which is mounted on the, this is mandrel, mounted on the mandrel. So this steel cylindrical workpiece is called the mandrel. So on the mandrel, the feeler is mounted. And then we need to set the pointer of the needle of the dial indicator to zero position. So once you set the zero position, then you can move the carriage from one, move the carriage so that the dial indicator will move from one end to the another end of the mandrel. So if there is any error in the parallelism of the line of centers, then the dial indicator will show the reading. So let us see. So how much it varies. Now you can see, so it is zero position. So it is moved backward through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 divisions. So the least count of this dial indicator is, you know, 0.01 mm. So this can be used for measuring the linear dimensions of 0 to 25 mm. Okay, the what is the maximum error is 7 into 0.01. So 7 is the pointer reading, that is it up to it is 5 and 6, 7. That means 7 divisions error is there, 7 into 0.01 mm. That is 0.07 mm is the error in the parallelism in the line of centers. Next, coming to the another test, second test is movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed. So for this also, the dial indicator stand is mounted on the upper slide, and then the dial indicator feeler, so this is the feeler, which is mounted on the, placed on the, so this is the steel rod, right? Or mandrel. So at one end, we place the feeler of the dial gauge on the mandrel, and then we will set the zero position. So after setting the zero position, then we will use the upper slide. We will provide the movement to the upper slide by the screw. So let us see what is the variation. Now this upper slide screw is rotated. Upper slide screw is rotated. Now we are setting the zero position. After setting zero position, so we'll use the upper slide screw for providing the movement to the upper slide. Now it is in zero position. Now we are rotating this. So the feeler is moving over the mandrel. And you see, observe, you see the, what is the position of the, that is error, right? The deviation is observed by the pointer. Now we can observe, right? So what is the maximum? Right here it is zero position, and then it is moved backward, right? It is 10 divisions, it is 10 divisions, 20, it is again 10 divisions, 30 divisions, right? So here the pointer is moved in the backward, right? It is 10 divisions, it is 10 divisions, again it is 10 divisions. total 30 divisions. It is pointer is moved backward. That means the error is 30 divisions. So therefore, 30 into 0.01 is the error in the movement of the upper slide. That is 0.3 mm is the error. But maximum allowed is 0.02 mm for 300 mm or 600 mm length. So the error is more in the upper slide movement. Next, I will show so how the that is tailstock parallel to the bed. So here, so we are mounting the dial indicator stand on the upper slide, and then this feeler is mounted on the barrel of the tailstock. Now the dial indicator is placed, the feeler of the dial indicator is placed on the barrel, and we are setting the pointer to zero position by rotating this bezel. So this is called the bezel, this round one is bezel, and it is set to zero position. Now we will rotate the this handle, right, to move the barrel in and out. So here we are moving the carriage, and carriage is moved, and then the feeler of the dial indicator is moved over the barrel and shown the reading. So because it is parallel to the bed, so the carriage is moved. So what is the maximum error observed? So the maximum error observed is, so it is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14th division. 14th division. That is 14 into 0.01 will give the 0.14 mm is the error. Tailstock parallel to the bed. And the next one is, true running of the headstock center. Now we place the dial indicator stand on the saddle, and then the feeler of the dial indicator is placed perpendicular to this taper surface, and then this headstock center is rotated by means of this belt, by means of the belt. So if you pull the belt, the headstock spindle will rotate, and then we will note down the what is the reading or error in the true running of the headstock center on the dial indicator. Either you can place on the right headstock center or on the cone shaped on the tapered shape of the headstock center. So we will use the belt, and we pull the belt so that there is a kind of belt is connected to two pulleys. So if we rotate, the headstock center will rotate. And you can observe the maximum is 1 or 2 divisions. So here maximum two divisions, so it is moving. Maximum error observed is two divisions on the dial indicator. So 2 into 0.01 is the least, right? 0.01 is the least count. So 2 divisions into 0.01 is the error in true running of the head stock center. So the maximum is 2 is observed. Now we need to report the results in the table. So true running of the headstock center, what is the error? 2 divisions maximum into the least count is 0.01. So we will get maximum error is 0.02 mm. So it is within the allowable error. And the movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed, it is a maximum error is observed is 0.3 mm. So 30 divisions is moved backward. So 30 into 0.01 is 0.3 mm. And the line of centers parallel to the bed observed as 0.07 mm. And the tail stock parallel to the bed, we observed 14 into 0.01, that is 0.41 mm. So the maximum error observed from this table is 0.3 mm. After that, it is 0.14 mm. Now we need to report the results under the results section. So true running of the headstock center is 0.02 mm. Movement of the upper slide parallel to the bed is 0.3 mm. Line of centers parallel to the bed is 0.07 mm. Tail stock parallel to the bed is 0.14 mm. So from the results, you need to draw the conclusion. So from the results, it is observed that so the maximum error is 0.3 mm is observed for the test moment of the upper slide parallel to the bed. And the second maximum error is observed for the test tail stock parallel to the bed is 0.14 mm. So this test we can conduct for the machine tool manufacturing industries conducts this type of tests to check the accuracy of the machine tools. So the applications of this test is in machine tool manufacturing industries. Okay, so in this way we have to conduct the alignment test or a geometrical test for checking the accuracy of the various parts of the lathe machine. Similarly, we can conduct the alignment tests on the milling machine. We can conduct the alignment tests on the grinding machine, shaping machine, slotting machine. So in all the drilling machines, we can conduct the alignment tests. So this is about this video. Thank you.